Hello, my dear friends. So welcome to the next example on mesh analysis. So in this circuit, we are going to discuss two voltage sources are there, right? So this is nothing but the circuit that we are going to solve for finding out the current I1 and I2. Okay. So in previous example, we have seen only one voltage source were there in the particular circuit, right? And it was consisting of only resistors and inductors. Now over here, the capacitor also added in this circuit, right? So let us see how to apply the mesh analysis for such kind of circuit. Okay, so let us apply KVL to loop number one. Applying KVL to loop number one. Okay, so 10 angle 45 is equals to 2 plus J2 to bracket I1 plus, now the central arm, that is nothing but the shunt arm, is consisting of one resistor and in series with that capacitor is there. Okay, so from that two currents are flowing, again they are in a same direction, right? Both the currents are flowing in a downward direction, so therefore 3 minus J3. So remember that whenever there is a capacitor, the minus sign will be associated with that. Fine? Okay. So 3 minus J3 into I1 plus I2. Are you getting it? As these two currents are flowing in a same direction, so they simply get added. Right? So now club the terms of I1 and I2. So 2 plus J2 plus 3 minus J3 into I1, send it. So whenever we are going to multiply this bracket to this I1 and I2, I will be getting 3 minus J3 I1. Okay, so that I have added with this term, isn't it? Plus 3 minus J3 I2. Is that fine? Okay, now again simplify this bracket. So 2 plus 3, it is going to become 5, and J2 added with minus J3, it is going to become minus 1J. Okay, this is nothing but your I1 term, and I2 is nothing but 3 minus J3. Okay, I2. So let us mark this as equation number 1. Okay, so this is nothing but 10 angle 45, and this is nothing but your equation number 1. Fine. Okay, now let us find equation number 2. Okay, applying KVL to, now let us take a different color, applying KVL loop number 2. So in this loop also there is a 15 angle 30 is the voltage source, AC voltage source. So 15 angle 30 is equals to 1 minus J2 I2 plus 3 minus J3 into bracket I1 plus I2. Is that fine? Okay, now let us simplify this again. 15 angle 30 is equals to 1 minus J2 plus 3 minus J3. This is multiplied with I1 plus 3 minus J3 into bracket I1. This must be I2 and this must be I1. Okay, fine. So finally 15 angle 30 is equals to, rearrange this equation after addition and subtraction, so 1 plus 3 is going to become 4, and then minus J2 minus J3 is going to become minus J5. So this is I2 plus 3 minus J3 I1. So finally, three minus J three I one plus four minus J five I two. Okay, so this is nothing but equation number 2. Is that fine? So let us rewrite those equations. 10 angle 45 is equals to 5 minus J1 I1 5 minus J1 I1 plus 3 minus J3 I2. Equation number 1. 15 angle 30 is equals to 3 minus J3 I1 plus 4 minus J5 I2. This was your equation number 2, isn't it? Yes, exactly. Now let us make I1 or I2 term common. What is the simplest way to make it common? So simply we just multiply by this term to equation number 1, okay, and you just multiply by this term to equation number 2. Okay, so let us write it: multiplying by 3 minus J3 to equation number 1 and by 5 minus J1 to equation number 2. Okay, we will get. Okay, now remember that whenever you are going to multiply by 10 angle 45 into 3 minus J3, you need to convert that. Either this you need to convert into A plus JB form, or this you need to convert into R plus JB form, because they are in both the quantities are in different forms. Okay, so this is in the a polar form and this one is in the rectangular form. So you need to convert either of it in a other form. Okay, so either you can go for converting this R and theta into AB form, or and else you can go for converting this rectangular form to the R and theta form. Okay, we'll do it. Fine. Okay, so over here now 5 minus J1 into bracket 3 minus J3 I1, don't forget the I1 terms. Okay, now 3 minus J3 into 3 minus J3, it's bracket square actually, so it is I2. Okay, now let us convert this in the form of R and theta. So 10 angle 45 into R and theta is nothing but, okay, so let us convert this over here. So R is equals to under root of 3 minus 3 square plus 3 square. Okay, it is nothing but, let us calculate it, under root of 3 square plus 3 square, it is becoming 4.24. So it is 4.24, sorry, 30 is equals to 4.24. okay, and theta, let us calculate, 10 inverse of 3 by 3, 10 inverse of 1 is 45. Okay, so theta is 45. Is that fine? So over here 4.24 angle 45. Okay, so let us expand this one. So 5 threes are 15 minus J15, now minus J15 Okay, now let us multiply by minus g3 to this bracket. Okay, fine. So we have multiplied by 3 first. So 3 5s are 15 and 3 into g1. Sorry, it is not 15. Sorry. Okay, so let us multiply by 3 to this bracket. So 3 5s are 15 minus 1 into 3 is minus g3. Okay, now let us multiply by minus g3 to this bracket. So minus g15 minus minus, it is going to become plus j square. Okay, and 1 into 3 is 3 i1 plus, now it is going to become a minus b bracket square. So 3 into 3 is 9, okay, minus j9. Now let us multiply by minus g9, minus minus become, it is going to become plus j square 9, okay, I2. Now let us multiply by 4 into 4.25 into 10. So 10 into 4.24, it is going to become 42.5, and angles are going to get added. So whenever there is a multiplication of angles, they are going to get added, right? Okay, so 45 plus 45 is going to become 90. So 90 is the angle. Now I'll simplify this. So j square is going to become minus 1. Okay, fine. So 15 minus 3. Okay, so once I am going to replace this j square by minus 1, then it is going to become minus 3. Okay, so 15 minus 3 is going to become 12. And the addition of these two is nothing but minus of g18. Is that fine? So this is nothing but the term of I1. Okay, plus, okay, again for this one, I have my square, j square is equals to minus 1. So it is going to become 9 minus 9, it is going to become 0, right? And this is going to become what? Minus of 18. Okay, so minus j18 will be the remaining term in case of I2. Okay, so this is nothing but our simplified equation after doing multiplication with that bracket. So let us see, this is my equation number third. Is that fine? Okay, great. Now let us go for the next one. Let us go for this equation, right? Okay, let me take the another color. So over here as well, 15 angle 30. Okay, so 15 angle 30 into now 5 minus j1, 5 minus j1. So here also we need to convert that in terms of r and theta form, right? Okay, so 3 minus j1 into the bracket 5 minus 1 j i1 plus 4 minus j5 into bracket 5 minus g1 i2. Is that fine? Okay, now let us convert this, now let us convert this into r and theta. Okay, I'll be directly converting and I'll be directly writing it. Okay, so you just calculate it as per your convenience. So 5 square plus 1 square it is going to become 5.099. so 15 एंगल 30 मल्टीप्लाइड बाय 5.09, एंगल इज टेन इनवर्स ऑफ माइनस 1/5, इट इज कमिंग एज माइनस 11.30, माइनस 11.30, ओके इज इक्वल टू. सो आफ्टर मल्टीप्लाइंग दिस आई विल बी गेटिंग दिस बिकॉज आई हैव ऑलरेडी डन दिस वन, इजंट इट. सॉरी आई फॉरगॉट टू राइट दिस एज G3, सॉरी, ओके यस. सो दिस इज द आंसर. ओके सो आई विल बी डायरेक्टली राइटिंग दैट 12 माइनस J18. So I'm not going to repeat the same. Okay, fine. Now I'm going to repeat. I'm going to calculate this one. Okay, so 4 5s are 20 minus G25. So we have multiplied by 5 inside this bracket minus G1. Now let us multiply by minus G1. So minus G1 into 4 is going to become minus G4. Minus minus is going to become plus. Then J into J is going to become J square. 5 into 1 is going to become 5. Is that fine? Okay. So this is nothing but the multiplied with I2. Okay. Now let us multiply by this. So 15 multiplied by 5.09 is equals to 76.35, and angles must be added, right? So 30 minus 11.30, it is becoming 18.7. So remember that whenever there is a multiplication of angles, you need to do the addition, right? So 30 added with this minus 11.30, I will be getting 18.7. Okay, is equals to 12 minus J18. I forgot to write I1 over here. Okay, this is I1, right? Plus, now what about this? So 20 is over here, right? And this J square is going to become minus 1. So 20 minus 5, it is going to become 15. Minus 25, and this minus J24, it is going to become minus J29 into I2. Is that fine? Okay, so let us go to the next page. Let us subtract these two equations from each other. Okay, so let us subtract equation number 4 from equation number 3. So for that we need to again reconvert these two quantities into A plus JB form. Okay, fine. So let us convert it first. Okay, so a is nothing but what? It's r and theta, that is r cos theta. R is nothing but 42.5 cos of 90. Okay, so it is going to become 0 because cos 90 is 0. So 0 plus j. Now let us check out j. Now simply instead of cos, we just put it as sine, then it is going to give you sine 90 is 1, right? So 42.5 is the value, okay? 42.5j is equals to the remaining term, 12 minus J18 I1 minus J18 I2. Okay, so for this we have converted in terms of A plus JB form. Now let us go for this one. Okay, fine. Now let us go for this one. R is nothing but 76.35 cos of 18.7. It is going to result as 72.31 plus J. Now sine is 24.47 is equals to 12 minus J18, rest of other things are same, plus 15 minus J29, I2. Is that fine? And we are going to subtract it. Yes. Okay. Fine. So it is going to become minus 72.31. Right. So from this 42.5 minus 24.47. 42.7 minus 24.47, it is going to result as plus 18 plus J 18.23 is equals to, this is going to get cancelled out, right? Okay, minus 15, minus minus is going to become plus, so from 29, 18 will be subtracted, that is coming as plus J11 into I2. Is that fine? Okay. Now reconvert this and this in terms of R and theta. Okay. So let us convert it under root of minus. Okay. Minus is going to become plus after making square. So I am directly writing as minus 72.31. It's a bracket square. Plus 18.23 bracket square. It is resulting as 74.57. And let us calculate now angle. Tan inverse of 18.23 divided by minus 72.31. So it is coming as, angle is coming as plus 14.14 is equals to, value of angle is minus, coming as minus. Okay, so minus 14.14. Okay, now convert this under root of 15 square plus 11 square is coming as 18.60. So it is coming as 18.60. So no need to write it again. Okay. So no need to write those formula. You can directly calculate it. Okay. It's for your understanding purpose. I have written it many times. Fine. So 11 divided by 15. Minus 11 divided by 15. So it is coming as minus 36 point. Angle is coming as minus 36.25. This is the value of I2. Okay, multiplied by I2. Now let us divide this. So 74.57. Angle is minus 14.14. And divided by 18.60, angle is minus 36.25 is equals to I2. So it is coming as, so 74.57 I can directly divide by 18.60. So it is coming as 4.4009, and angles we are going to get subtracted. Okay, so minus 14.14, and it is going to get added with the 36.25, because minus minus is going to become plus, right? So it is going to become, angle is going to become 22.11 is the value of angle. This is nothing but the value of I2. Okay. Now let us put this value of I2 in any of the equation. Let us say equation number 1. Okay. Okay, now putting the value of I2 in equation number 3. Is that fine? Okay, so let's add new one. Okay, so the value of I1, our value of I2, we are going to put it in this equation, equation number 3. This is nothing but equation number 3. Okay, so let us put it. Now we need to convert that in terms of a plus jb form. Okay, so let us convert that in terms of a plus jb form so that we can multiply with the j18. Okay, so 4.009 cos of 22.11 is coming as J18 multiplied by, it is 3.714, and let us find out now its J value. So it is coming as plus J1.508. Okay, now let us do multiplication. 12 minus J18 I1 minus into 18 into 3.714 is coming as minus J66.852 minus 18 into 1.508 is coming as minus J square 27.144. Okay, so J square is going to become plus 1. Okay, sorry, minus 1, and minus minus is going to become plus 1. Okay, so let us rearrange it. 12 minus J18 I1 minus J66.852 plus 27.144. Okay, great. Now let us take this whole term, because this is a constant term, no, to the left hand side. Okay, now parallelly again let us convert this in terms of R and theta, a plus jb form. So 42.5 cos of 90 is 0, so therefore it is going to be 0 angle 0 plus j 42.5. we have already calculated this. Okay, fine, great. Now let us take this term to the left hand side. So j 42.5 minus I minus is going to become, my J minus is going to become plus over here. So J 66.852, and that minus is going to become my that plus is going to become minus over here. Okay, is equals to 12.12 minus J 18 I1. Now let us rearrange this equation. So minus 27.144 plus 66.85 plus 42.5, it is coming as 109.35. So 109.35 is equals to 12 minus J18 I1. Okay, fine. Now next, Okay, now first convert it. Now for let us convert the values in terms of r and theta. Okay, so r for this one is nothing but 27, sorry, under root of 27.144, the root of 27.144 square plus 109.35 square. It is coming as r is coming as 112.66 and angle is coming as tan inverse of 109.35 divided by minus 27.144 is coming as minus 76.05. Okay, and this let us calculate now. Under root of 12 square plus 8, 18 square. So it is coming as 21.63. And let us calculate tan inverse of minus 18 divided by 12. It is coming as minus 56.30 multiplied by I1. So now angle minus 76.05 divided by 21.63 angle 56.30. Angle minus 56.30 is equals to I1. Okay. Now let us calculate this 112.66 divided by 21.63. That is coming as 5.208 and angles are going to get subtracted, right? So minus 76.05 that will be added with 56.30. So therefore minus 19.75 is the angle for I1. So this is nothing but the value of I1. Okay. So likewise you can calculate the values.